12.8% of all of Hawaii's high school students, based on a test that they took, a survey they took, have reported that they've either thought about suicide or they've attempted suicide. That has put us first in the nation for having our teens most at risk for ending their life by suicide.
You know, a lot of people have this, I'm tough, or guys especially, you know. Those are the ones that you really gotta watch out for, because when they reach that point, they won't know what to do. And to them, that might be their solution, because that's the only way they think that their pain will end.
She was a closed-off person, didn't say much, and I feel like if she opened up her feelings and told us how she really felt before she did this, I think things would change.
We're not in their shoes. We don't know what they're going through, too, because they could seem happy on the outside, but that is just for show sometimes, just to, you know, make your other family members feel happy. But deep down, they're probably suffering a lot.
Even though the suicide death toll is rising, there are ways to stop it, like keeping a watchful eye on our community for signs.
For somebody at risk can be pretty easy to recognize. They can be talking about suicide, first of all. They could say things, as I'd mentioned before, I'm thinking about ending it, I want to kill myself, I don't want to live anymore. It can be a little bit more subtle, like nobody would miss me if I wasn't here.
However, some people can hide these signs very well.
He was just a happy person. And we saw him two nights before, and because we were at the carnival and we were having fun. He was playing with the kids. But I never seen anything like this coming.
Suicide can be prevented. You can make a difference just by doing or saying something very little.
Even if it's a stranger, they look sad, just say hi. You might not have to say anything else. Just by you saying hi might make a difference. Because they're going to be like, wow, they notice me.
Suicide is a topic that shouldn't be taken lightly. To help each other, we may need to step into someone else's shoes to understand what they might be going through. If you or a loved one is at risk of suicide, talk about it and know you're loved by many people in your life. And if all else fails, call the National Suicide Hotline at 1-800-273-8255. This is Shane Shibuya from Chief Iskamakahele Middle School for Hikino.